This is the flight line at Luke Air Force Base. More pilots are trained here than any other place in the world. Trainers include the supersonic F-104s, the F-4 Phantoms, and the latest in super sophisticated jet fighters, the F-15 Eagle. It's literally the hottest air superiority fighter in the world. To fly in this magnificent machine is a thrilling experience, but getting the Air Force nod, it's almost impossible. As I suited up, I remembered the 2 years it took for clearance, requests that went through channels from the commanding general at Luke all the way to the chief of staff in Washington. Before the flight, I was taught emergency procedures that could save my life should an in-flight emergency occur. The Air Force garb included a G-suit that automatically tightens around the body as the aircraft accelerates through the tight maneuvers that would otherwise black out the occupants. Aircraft Commander Major Lynn McMahon is an F-15 instructor. He explained today's flight of two would be a tactical mission. His student would attempt to find us, get on our tail, and simulate shooting us down. Once on the flight line, it takes about 30 minutes to check out the aircraft and its systems. Nothing is left to chance. Lieutenant Colonel Dan Sherlock, a Vietnam veteran in the F-4 Phantom, is currently undergoing transition training to the Eagle. It will be his responsibility to find us, then get into a position to shoot us down. After all the checklists are satisfied, the flight of two Eagles is cleared for a maximum performance takeoff. The F-15's two powerful engines, producing 27,000 pounds of thrust each, can accelerate the aircraft in a vertical climb. It cruises in excess of Mach 2.5 and is capable of altitudes above 60,000 feet. Its armament is impressive, but classified. When the Eagle goes after its prey, it doesn't miss. Even for the layman, the Eagle is easy to fly. I had little trouble with aerobatic maneuvers, but could scarcely breathe during the dogfight maneuvers as we took evasive action to keep Colonel Sherlock off our tail.
Keep a little bit of back stick pressure on the stick there.
Okay.
That'll do it for you.
Okay. Yeah. Boy, it feels good.
Where he is, Jerry, he's a target coming down dead ahead there.
Okay.
And he's about 12 miles. Okay, he's at 11 o'clock out there, just above the horizon. About 5:30.
Oh, he got you, huh?
The flight lasted just short of 2 hours. My feelings were mixed. I felt like I had been shot into space on a rocket with the power and versatility to do anything I wanted. The Eagle and her pilots are magnificent, but most important, they are one of the reasons we are at peace with the world. Jerry Foster, Cool News 10.